nothing better to do, Mark.
Yeah, I've got nothing better to do.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to Monday Meander. And I've decided to, if I still decide to, but at the moment I'm still planning to go to Asda randomly. Anyway, this is Askew Road. Some people find it quite palatable. Oh, terrible joke. Anyway, quite windy today, isn't it? Do you know what I've never figured out? Why launderettes, or the coin-op, as my mum used to call them. I think mum still calls them coin-op. I don't think she's ever said launderette. But they always seem to attract vandalism for some unknown reason. Like, I don't know, who decides one day, oh, I'm just going to walk past this launderette and put a brick through a window. I don't understand. Who are these weirdos? Anyway, this is the road that I have to walk down because the bus that I need to get doesn't come down this way. It's at the top of this street. And that's where I'm deciding to, still at the moment, go to Asda. It's a 24-hour Asda, so there's no rush. Oh, look. It's a fish bar where the fish go to get drunk. It's a fish and chip shop. It's so pretentious when places say fish bar. Anyway, it doesn't look as if it's got any sweating spinny kebab, so I should really have a look, shouldn't I? Oh, I can smell it. Looks like a proper chippy. Not too far from me either. Anyway, I'm nearly on the bus. 13 minutes away by bus, it says. And that's the Tramp Transport terminus, but I'm at the Loser Cruiser stop right now. And yes, just gotta wait now. That's quite derogatory terms for a bus, isn't it? But I'm not really a bus person. And I prefer to get the tube. I could have got the tube, but I didn't. It involves a bit more walking. Oh, disco bus, blue lights. Anyway, I'll wait here then, shall I? I won't have to wait long. How many times does it say? About every 11 to 13 minutes, it says. So it's not too bad for London times. Yeah, so this is where I prefer to get the tube everywhere, because most of the time it's only a couple of minutes as a tube. Look at me at the back of the top deck. This is where the naughty kids sit. Naughty's in misbehaved. Window open, of course. I don't want to breathe in the riff-raff breath. So what? Grief, that sound is still up, look. It's like a sketch of a sound. Here we am, I've been to this Asda a few times, so I just don't like coming to this Asda. Not that there's anything wrong with it, but getting to it is not particularly a great experience. It's halfway through the bus route, so I don't get to sit on the bus seat that I want to. And obviously got to time it right as well, because the last thing you want to do is to come to a supermarket when all the riffraff have kicked out of their institution. You know, kids leaving school, that situation. Because it's a big supermarket, obviously, and you always get crap parents who can't look after the kids these days. Oh, it just lit up. I think Asda agrees. There's just too many parents who just can't look after the kids in a supermarket these days, and it drives them around the bleeding bend. Anyway, it's probably going to be quite busy. Ooh, look at all the tomatoes, all that faffing around in the media saying, hey, there's no tomatoes. I mean, since when does anyone eat veg anyway? All the people kicking off saying there was no vegetables, what am I going to do? It's like, well, half the time you're told you're wasting them, and the second of all, you're saying you're not eating enough, and as soon as they're not there, you're all kicking off saying that there's no fruit and veg. Well, there's blooming loads of it. Anyway, I need a drink. I'm quite thirsty. I should start at the beginning, really, shouldn't I? It's a very good place to start. That's Asda George, that's where you get the clothes from. I used to like George, I used to get loads of clothes from George when I lived in Hull. I'd rather you go to George than Primark. But it's just hard to get to an Asda these days for me. And that's fun, a PlayStation bed set. Reversible design, exclamation mark. Why, what's on the other side? I bet it's just that on the other side, isn't it? Yeah, it is. well, that's fun. Ugh, Henry. We've made over 10 million Henrys, and most of them are still in use for today. I think you should have reworked that, and I can't stand Henry Hoovers, but I think you should just say 10 million Henrys so long lasting, or something like that. You shouldn't say, and most are still in use today, because most could mean more than half, which could mean if they've made 10 million, 5 million and one. You know, got to rethink these things. That's the scary number that always follows me around, 159. Everything's always 159. Anyway, I might have a look at some of the... No, I'm not going to have a look at the clothes. I've got no money at all. I shouldn't even be here, really. What is it with underpowered microwaves these days? 700 watt? They was on the way out when I went to Argos. That was flipping nearly 20 years ago now. Might actually be 20 years flipping, heck. 2003. Oh, my word! 20 years ago. Ice Master. That's made by Dare You. That's just a name now that anyone can buy and slam on the stuff. So it's probably not by Dare You at all. That was weird. Someone's ditched the kidney beans and chopped tomatoes. Because they decided to buy a bamboo caddy instead. Oh, that's funny. A decision was made. It's clearly the Techmoan section, isn't it? You never see him review anything from Asda. I bet all this sounds terrible. I don't see any cassette decks, but I do see a portable CD player, still 18 quid, 60 second anti-shock protection, so you can actually put this in the car if you wanted to, or you could run for 60 seconds then stop. Actually, they could use this as a lose weight aid, couldn't they? Because all you'd have to do is 60 seconds of workout, and then you'd get to stop for good reasons, listen to your song for 60 seconds, and then for 60 seconds, run again. What a plan. It's the CD Asda plan. Are you a fatso like me? Lose weight. Just do 60 seconds of workout a day. Is it a dab? Or is it, it's only an AM, FM. That's still quite expensive, isn't it, for that? Oh, little baby one. And it's the big clav section. Just needs to spudge her up on one of these apparently branded Duracell torches and see if they're any good. Well, if you're still switched on to this video, are you enjoying it so far? Let me know in the comment section. Oh, I do need be a good idea if I buy a light bulb, because mine randomly went. Do you know, I don't think I've ever seen an LED light bulb break and then two happened at once. It's like buses. I think LED bulbs are the new bus. One doesn't break and then they all seem to break at once. I need a bayonet cap though, I don't want screwing. God, at the day. Back in the day, for a pound you'd get a 4-pack of 100 watt light bulbs. Not paying all that. Anyway, that's a ridiculous amount for that. I'm not paying that for a light bulb. Oh look, it's a tele autobiography by Prince Harry called Wah!
Oh, I had such a tough upbringing. Oh, things were so difficult for me. Oh, it's so tough being a prince.
Look what someone's put it in front of. That's hilarious. I didn't even do that. That was somebody else. Anyway, that's hilarious, as if someone put it there. Oh, this just reminded me of a paper chase actually going bust again. Got bought by Tesco randomly. I don't know why it's such a random purchase for Tesco, but they've bought it. Sharpie pens. I've got enough of that. Well, I think we'll get a couple of pizzas because I did eat Sherlock's pizza out the freezer. But I'll get them chilled ones. That'd be nice, wouldn't it? I'll get barbecue chicken, I think. What's that? Chicken fajita. Yeah, I'll get chicken fajita and barbecue chicken. Mix and match two for a fiver. That's still quite expensive for pizza, but it is to me. But I'm going to get it anyway. Yeah, I'm sure it's not just me, but don't you just hate it when you're walking down the aisle of a supermarket and you're a good few paces away from somebody you've just walked by, but you can still smell the bad breath. I hate it so much. Right, I want some cheap Marge, which is not something you can find these days. Can't believe it's not butter. See, they changed the name back, didn't they? Because they changed the name and now they've changed it back and no one give a damn. I think they was banking on a Coca-Cola situation or Cocoa Pops. And they bring back the original name and no one gives a damn. Anyway, what shall I get? It looks as if it's, I can't believe it's the cheapest. Oh no, got some Asda own stuff. Brilliantly buttery. Is it? Well, you're in the basket now, so you better add be. I'm really thirsty, I need a drink. Fragrant and tasty tomato juice. Now, I don't think tomatoes are a good smell. I like tomatoes very much. I like tomato juice, tomato sauce, tomatoes. But particularly even tomato plants, you can't say that they smell particularly fragrant. Well, you can, but it's not a good fragrance, is it? Oh, what's this? Nah, I don't want a summer fruit stuff. Blueberry juice drink? Maybe. Oh, I saw rhubarb and I thought, oh, rhubarb, but they've mixed it with ginger. Don't want that. Ginger makes me really, really hot. Pineapple and lime. Win-win, I like pineapple, I like lime. I'll get that, £1.70. That's quite expensive. It looks quite juicy, like all the juices stuck to the bottom, look. Shall I just treat myself? Shall I treat myself? Oh, it's two for £3. Do you know what? No, I can't afford it. Oh, well, that's something I would have loved to have tried, but I can't justify spending that amount of money on a juice. Who decided juice was so expensive anyway? Oh God, I feel like I can't even afford orange juice. I mean, it's Anita Bryan all over again. I don't want to touch the orange juice. It's too expensive. Oh, Sunny D. Remember when Sunny Delight was like at the height of its fame? I can't believe people still buy it, actually. I can't believe it's still in the fridge when it needn't be in the fridge. I'd come to the spices bit, but it looks as if they've run out of time. That's a pun. I think they have. Yeah. Oh well. Plenty of basil, bay leaves, rosemary, parsley, oregano, but no thyme. I've probably missed it. I bet everyone else has seen it except me. Oh well. Poppy seeds. Nutmeg. I think nutmeg sounds funny. I don't want any sauces. Got plenty of condiments already. And Branston pickle. I think I've got enough at home. Premium haggis. Flipping heck, HP beans. You don't see much of them anymore. And clearly people are still buying them. There are plenty of Hans left. HP used to be the rival to Hans until Hans bought the HP beans brand. And obviously Branston is best as well. Branston beans are the best. They're just so much better. But £2.25 for a pack of three, or £3 for a pack of four. Now usually it's £2.50 for a pack of four everywhere else. So I'm not really sure which is the best. You see, this is why you get shopping. Everything's a flipping maths exam. It's so difficult to know the prices of everything these days. Oh yeah, the Asda rewards thing, isn't he? Which I'm not going to get because I think this is my first trip to Asda this year. And last year, I think I went once, maybe twice. And then the year before that, maybe once or twice. What a downfall for pot noodle, isn't it? Pot noodle just never really captured the higher end brands of noodle out of a pot eating, did they? Remember when I lived a month on pot noodle? It was surprisingly easy because of all the choice, but I don't think I'd do it again. I always think Dolmio and Dormio mattresses are two names that are too close to each other. One's a cooking sauce and one's a mattress. Doritos Burger King Whopper flavour. Well, that's a flavour I've got to try, isn't it? Actually, I hope that tastes what the old Doritos used to taste like, because they used to taste really nice. It's another thing that really knocks me off as well at the moment. The prices of flora. I used to get it all the time. It used to be in every cheap shop for a pound. And then since the Woohoo flu situation a couple of years ago, the price has nearly doubled, or has doubled in some shops. What a rip-off. £5 for a big one. Ooh, look at me recorded, there's the camera. Well, if you're gonna film me, you're gonna film you. And we've got some butter.
This too is card only.
And I don't know the price of these. Oh, they were £1.75. There's no price on them. I've got a can of that for now, because I'm thirsty. £1.50, I'm sure it used to want to be a pound anyway. Right, these was meant to be two for a fiver, weren't they? So that's that one. Oh, come on, scan. There we go. That's that one. So it should be two for a fiver. Yes. Good, good, good. And I got myself a nice big bottle of dandelion and burdock. Now, we ate this diet nonsense. I wanted the full sugar one just because it tastes better. But hey ho. And how much was that going to be? £10.15. No bags, I got my own.
We just need to approve this.
Approve what?
Is coming to help.
Oh, yeah. Cheers, thank you. Right, I'm not going to get my card out on camera, am I?
Would you like your receipt?
Yes, I would.
Please take your receipt.
I will take my receipt. That's slightly green on the back. Good, good, good. And that was my Monday meander to Asda. It's quite dull for me, actually. But sometimes it's nice because sometimes it's nice just to anonymously go to Asda. And I mean, apart from that little bit you saw me at the till, I look and feel a right mess at the moment. But yeah, that's them really tall towers of trash, really. I can't understand what the difference between that is and the concrete slabbed together towers of the 1960s. I can't imagine anything worse than living in one of them tall tower blocks. Not many people say, oh, that's where maybe they can only afford to live. No, that's not affordable housing, which doesn't exist in London. That is just building high to maximise money as possible. That is awful. And there's loads of them going up as well in London at the moment. Anyway, I need to get the bus. Not that one, obviously. Oh, traffic stopped. Lovely. Anyway, make my way home. Oh, I think there's two buses I can get from here, actually. Yes, there is. I can either get the 260 or the 440. Whichever's first, then. I think this bus driver must be on a break or something. I just popped into Asda to go to the Macadies that's in there. Good, good, good. I've got the front top deck with the window. Martins can breathe. Lovely. Home again, jiggity jig. I had no idea a Lidl had opened on this corner. It's like a stealth Lidl, just blink and a Lidl opens. Wish it was an Aldi. Because this road is always like this. And he knew something was going to happen. And this time, it's this van that was just jumped quite a lot of traffic just to get on nowhere, really. I wonder if he'll try going for it when he's not supposed to. Stopped on a crossing as well. And they're not going to get far because this road's usually full of traffic as well. Aww. See, sometimes karma just does not work. This road always made me laugh. That's the Nimbus bus stop because it's Ware Moult Road. It's the either left or right, whatever. But I just think of Stop the Worms, Ware Moult Road. Stop the Worms. Stop the Worms.
260 to White City.
On that road. Oh, I missed it. It was to the left. Streets like this. Clearly the houses were built in the mid to maybe early 1800s. Oh, there's a car coming up a gate off the road, isn't there? The road's that quiet, they probably just think it was a speed bump as I get run over by car after car after car. Found a very old letterbox. It's got VR on it. I don't know if you can see in this light because it's quite dark now. VR means Victoria. I don't think I've been down this street before. Hi everybody, and now I'm back. It's time to edit together this very video. Boop boop be doop. Anyway, thanks for watching. Scrubs. I know these random under meanders are very random. I never really plan what I'm going to do. I think the most planning I've ever done on a Monday meander is what I did last week. Not last week, the week before. Anyway, bye!